snow fell and the wind howled. People hurried happily along the dark street on their way home to the fine dinners of roast goose and all the other wonderful things to eat. Standing barefooted and shivering against a wall was a little match girl. In her apron, she held bundles of matches for sale. But none of the happy people who hurried past stopped to buy anything. She hadn't sold a single package of matches all day long. How cold her hands felt. If only she dared to take one of the matches from a bundle and rub it against the wall and warm her hands at the flame. Oh, how good that would feel. Before she knew it, she had slipped out a match and rubbed it against the wall. And it made a wonderful light, so warm and so cozy. It seemed now to the little match girl as though she sat in front of a great warm stove in which a splendid fire roared and sang. And then suddenly, poof, it was all gone. And it was once more cold and dark and miserable. Quickly, she rubbed the second match against the wall. And again, the warm, happy light flared up. But this time, the wall behind her seemed to melt away, and she could look into the room beyond it. And the room was set for a gorgeous New Year's feast, with a big roast goose on the table, and piles of fresh baked bread and pies and cakes. It was so warm and smelled so good when, poof, out went the match. And once again, the splendid vision vanished. Oh, she could hardly get the next match out quickly enough. And with trembling fingers that were blue with the cold, she struck the match against the wall. This time she was sitting under a great, beautiful Christmas tree, glowing with lights and shining ornaments. Oh, it was breathtaking. Eagerly, the little girl stretched her hands out to touch the wonderful tree, and poof! It too was gone. All that was left was the wind and the snow and the awful cold, which seemed colder now than ever. She dared not waste another match, and yet, what could she do? Just one more, that would be all. Just one more, she promised herself. Went the match, and it became bright again. And in all the brightness, her dear, dead grandmother stood clear and shining, mild and lovely. Grandmother, cried the child, oh, take me with you. I know you will go when the match burns out. You will vanish like the warm fire and the warm food and the great, glorious Christmas tree. And she quickly rubbed the whole bundle of matches, because she wanted her grandmother to stay. The matches burned with such a glow that it was brighter than the middle of the day, and the grandmother took the little match girl in her arms, and both flew in brightness and joy above the earth, very, very high, up to where there was neither hunger nor cold. They were in heaven. And when the frozen little match girl was found the next morning, no one knew or could even imagine what a beautiful thing she had seen and to what a glorious new home she had gone with her grandmother on that New Year's Eve.